Hi, welcome back to Mr. Duncan's Chinese Takeaway. Well, it's been another busy week, and of course, as usual, I've been in the school teaching English, that's my job, and also doing some other things as well. You may remember last week I was due to have a visit from the local government. They were going to come to my house and inspect the surroundings here. But in the end, they decided not to. They visited my school, and as soon as they found out that the person they were looking for was Mr. Duncan, they said, "Ah, we know him. We know him very well." So they decided not to come and visit me. So that was quite nice. Nice to be trusted. So nobody came to my house last week in the end. As I said, I've been busy in the school with teaching the students. Maybe it's interesting to note that the ages of my students varies quite a lot. I teach from four-year-olds, very small children, right up to 104-year-olds. So basically anybody at any level. So I have many classes to teach during the week, including a primary class, kindergarten class, and also middle school class, high school class, and adult as well. So many different levels of teaching in my school, and I'm very lucky that I can take part in all of these classes. So my teaching experience now has widened a lot since 2003, so I feel very proud of this achievement. Many students ask me, and it's a common question, how can I improve my English? Well, as I mentioned before, there are many ways of improving your English. Reading is a very important part of learning English, listening, but as I've already said in another video, practice is the best way. You must try and create an English environment. If you are a student in school, maybe you are studying English in school, and maybe you feel very frustrated because you have very little chance to speak English. Maybe you can ask your teacher if they could arrange a small English corner within the school. For example, in my school, I have coordinated two English corners, and we have one every fortnight, which seems to work rather well and has received very good response. So maybe that's a good idea. If you are in school and you feel as if there's no real English environment within your school, maybe you could suggest it to one of your teachers to arrange a small English corner to give you a chance to use English with your classmates. Another problem that many students have is the way they view English. Many students view English as a subject, and I really do think that's a big mistake if you start to do that. If you see English as just another subject, similar to history or geography, it's a big mistake. What you should do is actually see English as a skill. You should see it as something that you need, rather like air or food. Think of it as part of your body, like your arm or your leg. So try to think of English in a different way. See it as something you need. See it as something that could be part of you, instead of just looking at it as another subject. Anyway, my time is running out, as usual, because I always like to talk. So I will see you next week. Take care, enjoy English, and good luck.